Hi, it's John, and welcome to Cycling on a Shoestring, and you're looking for a smartwatch. And you're here to take a look at the latest version from Mobvoi. Now, if you've been part of my channel for a while, maybe you subscribe, and if you haven't, please subscribe to the channel, almost at 1,000 subscribers here. You may have seen a video I did back in April of 2021 called Cycling with the Ticwatch Pro 3 GPS. A lot of people appreciated that I went out for a long ride on the bike to show how it would integrate with Strava and ride with GPS. So if you're interested in finding out how it works on a ride, watch that video. I'll put a link in the description below. I've been wearing this watch every day since I did that video, and I have loved this watch. As a matter of fact, I've loved it all the way along up until I picked up this watch right here, which I've had on my wrist for the last week or so, the Ticwatch Pro 3 Ultra GPS. Now the question is, what are the differences and how are they the same? Well, I'll tell you this right off the bat, they're a lot the same. Is it worth to get an upgrade to this watch? I'm gonna put them side by side right now, tell you how they are the same, how they are different, and maybe whether you should be picking up this new watch if you're already wearing the previous version. So let's put them side by side right now and talk about them, and maybe you can make a decision by looking at this watch right now on Cycling on a Shoestring. Here we have the two watches side by side, and as you can see, they're almost exactly the same. There's a few cosmetic differences between the two watches. On the left, the original version, Ticwatch Pro 3 GPS. On the right side is the new version, which is the Ultra. And the cosmetic differences are the watch bands, 22 millimeter watch band, hundreds of different options out there if you want to change that up. They both come with the rubberized watch band, which feels really comfortable. On this side, you might notice that this has got like a knurled look around the face, on the ring around the face. The buttons as well are like that, where they're smooth on the original version. These do not turn. Again, it's just a cosmetic difference between the watches. They're virtually the same size. The Ultra, the new version, apparently is 0.1 millimeter thicker, which you cannot feel a difference in the two watches at all. Same color, same weight, same chipset, Snapdragon 4100, and the Mobvoi dual processor system. They both got 1 gigabyte of RAM, 8 gigabytes of ROM. They're both 1.4 inches, so the display is the same. They've got Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, all of that stuff. They monitor your health, your blood saturation. They've got Google Pay, and they've got the same GPS. So these watches are a lot the same, basically the same operating system running in them as well. I'll talk about the wear version in just a moment. Now, what's different between these two watches? There are a few differences. First off, a little more personalization on the Ultra version. Let's see if I can get this to work right now. So when you tilt your watch and you're wanting to see it at night, a light comes on so you can see the color of it. And as you can see the one on the right, it turns red. You have a whole bunch of different options for that underlying screen that gives you the time all the time, because it's a dual screen watch. You always have the time on there, but because you're not using the regular watch face, which I'll show you right here, you're not draining your battery as fast, okay? So that's the beauty of this watch, is that you've got that dual screen on there, your battery will last a lot longer, but you can customize the color on the Ultra, and there's all these different colors you can change it to for your own personal look of your watch. Now let's talk about the battery. Now it's claimed that the battery in the original version is 595 milliamp hours, where the Ultra is 577. On this watch right here, I'm still getting 3 days, which is what is claimed on the Mobvoi website. So 72 hours on this original watch over here. On this one, even with the smaller battery, I'm seeing about 4 days of charge. I charged it a couple of days ago. It's still got about 50% of its battery on this one right here. If we look right there, 49%. So I'm getting better battery life out of this one right now than I am out of the original version. And I was really happy to get 3 days of charge out of the watch. Now, some differences as well are some between the two watches. This one is a little bit different when it comes to what it's made of, according to the Mobvoi website. The original version, stainless steel and plastic, and this one, high strength nylon with fiberglass with stainless steel as well. Now, if you look at the one on the left, you can see it's got all these scratches around the outside of it. And this is something that happened to me a few weeks back. If you've been watching my channel, you know that I had a crash a couple of weeks back, And this watch actually saved my left arm from getting scratched up real bad because I slid on the watch. And that's what happened to the watch. I didn't realize this until I got home. And, you know, it's kind of a badge of honor here, but this watch is pretty damn tough. Didn't do anything to the screen at all, which I understand is Gorilla Glass. So it's going to be pretty tough. So this watch is pretty darn tough. Now, as far as durability, you can go out in the rain. You can do a regular swim with it. I wouldn't go too deep with it, but if you're in a pool, it will last in a pool. But on the new version, the Ultra version, they say it is also military STD810G for extra toughness. So this one apparently tougher than this watch. But as I said, this one already took a beating, or I guess we could say took a licking, and it kept on ticking. Now, as far as price goes on these watches, on this watch right here, you're looking at $239.99 Canadian at the Mobboy website. So the original version on this one, it's a pretty good deal right now, down from $399 to $306.66. So between $60 and $70 more for this version over this version. I'll tell you if it's worth an upgrade for you, if you've already got the original version, to go to this one before I end this video. What I want to show you now is basically how they look when it comes to their apps and how the apps work. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to stop the camera. I want to change the watches so that it's always on screen and I don't have the screen going off all the time. And I'll tell you about something that's a little bit of a pet peeve with these two watches right now. Although it's not an issue with Mobboy, it is an issue with Google Play. Okay, so I'll tell you about that in just a moment. Let me change the watches to always on screen and we can look at the apps and how the watch works. So here's a look at both watch faces, and apparently I can't put this on always on screen. You can do that with the watch face itself. But I want to just show you something real quick here when it comes to something that might be a game changer for you when it comes to buying these watches right now. Now, on the left, of course, this is the original version. You can see that I've got Strava on there, and if you're a bike rider, you want to have Strava on your watch. I've also got Ride with GPS on both watches. The Ultra does not have Strava on it, and that's because I can't download it right now. I downloaded Strava on this a year and a half ago, and I think Strava has changed their app now, so it won't work on either one of these watches. And I think it's because Strava is using the Wear OS 3 system, and neither of these watches are Wear OS 3. I think they're about 2.56 or 2.59, but they're expected to get Wear OS 3 soon. I got in touch with Mobboy. They sent me an email the other day saying they're basically waiting on Google to allow these watches to use Wear OS 3. So Strava is coming for you if you've got these watches right now. But in the meantime, there is a workaround. If you want to use Strava on these watches, it can be done. And I'm going to make a separate video on that because it's too much to get into on this video right now. So look for that very soon. I'll put it up if you're kind of suffering right now. Might be a deal changer or a game changer for you when it comes to buying either one of these watches right now. But there is something you can do to use Strava on the Ticwatch 3 Pro GPS and the Ultra as well. Now, would I upgrade from the original version to this version? I'll tell you about that in just a moment, and I'll give you my final thoughts on this watch, the Ultra version, in just a moment. My final thoughts on these two watches, the original version, which I've been wearing for about a year and a half, and the Ultra version, which I've been wearing for about a week. Would I upgrade? If you had this one on your wrist, should you upgrade to the Ultra version? No, I wouldn't do it. If this one didn't exist, I'm just fine with this one. They're almost the same watch, okay? So you'd be throwing another $306 Canadian into this one when this one would do basically the same thing. Now, this does have a few little extras on it. I mean, it's nice to be able to customize the watch face so it turns up red or green or blue or any color that you want, but I don't think it's really worth an upgrade. Now, if you're going to buy one or the other, that depends on how much money you've got in your pocket. $239.99 versus $306.99, $60 to $70 more, you can get the latest version of the watch, but you would be just fine with this one and saving yourself a little bit of money. If you want to go for it, go for this one as well. But overall, they're fantastic watches. I love these watches. That dual screen on there, the extra battery life you get because of it, is such a game changer when it comes to watches. Getting 3 days of battery life out of this one, and right now it looks like I'm getting 4 days of battery life out of this one. So these are really cool watches and I highly recommend them. And the beautiful thing about this is, it's not just a sports fitness watch. It can do some of that stuff, but it's a smart watch. You can take calls, you can receive calls, you can take text messages, you can receive them. Same thing with email. This thing does it all, and it's a really nice watch to have on your wrist. So I highly recommend both of them, but it's your choice on whether you buy this one or you buy this one, or if you want to upgrade. I hope this was a helpful video for you. If it was, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. We're darn close to 950 subscribers right now. I really want to get to 1,000. You can help me out with that. So do that. And also, you know, ring the bell so you get notifications. I'll see you next time on Cycling on a Shoestring.